I ask my colleagues to make a leadership change. A change because I believed that a good government was losing its way.
Just fucking hopeless. This is becoming hopeless. Tell them to cancel this meeting at 6 o'clock, will you? I'm going to have it. Fucking patience to do it.
No, the private health insurance rebate will be staying.
Labor will end the Pacific solution, the so-called Pacific solution, the processing and detaining of asylum seekers on Pacific Islands, because it is costly, unsustainable and wrong as a matter of principle.
There will be no carbon tax under the government I lead.
Certainly what we rejected is this hysterical allegation that somehow that we are moving towards a carbon tax from the Liberal and their advertising. We certainly reject that.
Given that Labor has never delivered a surplus in my lifetime, and that in his time as Treasurer, the government has delivered the four largest budget deficits in Australian history, will the Treasurer confirm that based on forecast surpluses, I will be 110 years old before the debt he has created in just 4 years has been paid off?
Most importantly, I'll ensure the budget is in surplus by 2013.
The 4 years of surpluses I announced tonight are a powerful endorsement of the strength of our economy.
Because it's in the interests of families right around the nation that we bring the budget to surplus. There couldn't be anything more in their interests.
It's appropriate that we return to surplus.
There is nothing in these numbers that deters the government from bringing down a surplus in 2012-13.
A surplus in the conditions that Australia finds itself is the responsible thing to do. It's appropriate that we return to surplus.
We're determined to deliver a surplus in 2012-13.
Determined?
Well, what we'll need to see tonight is the... Sorry.
Whoops.
But I would say this, it is an historic reform. It's the first time we've got this through the Parliament, a reform that's about spreading the benefits of the boom, delivering, using the higher profits of profitable miners, making sure they pay a reasonable rate to the Australian people, and through that funding cuts to the company tax system, plus investing in things like superannuation for working Australians. But good reform.
Consulting with the mining companies to ensure that we get the structure of this tax right, and we're out there talking to communities and talking to the mining companies and people that have
It was a masterful, landmark speech to the Lowy Institute in Sydney this morning with a surprising new element.
A regional processing centre removes the incentive, once and for all, for the people smugglers to send boats to Australia.
Aaron, it's trying to give the impression that everything's under control.
Here, 54 others picked up this morning near Scott Reef face a very different future. They'll be the first deported under the government's Malaysia solution.
Will life be perfect and easy for everybody sent to Malaysia? Of course it won't be.
No why I'll a wipe out there on my TV. No why I'll a wipe out there on my TV. No why I'll a wipe out there on my TV. Shocking me right out of my brain. Shocking me right out of my brain.
I'm too sexy for your party. Too sexy for your party. The way I'm disco dancing. I'm too sexy for my shirt. Too sexy for my shirt. So sexy it hurts. And I'm too sexy for Milan. Too sexy for Milan. New York and Japan.
Look, I've just given the best answer I can to your question.
My question was simply whether or not...
I heard your question and I've answered it.
You haven't answered the question.
Well, I've given you the answer I'm going to give you.
Oh, hello.
G'day.
I just heard your man out there saying no one's asked about the carbon tax.
Oh, I think it's probably one of our mediums, this one
probably
here.
Hello. Well, I said I'd just like to ask one.
Sure.
Why did you lie to us?
Right. Well, I can talk to you
and
about
why
that.
Are you continuing well, to lie and say, well, you know, I didn't really mean to lie?
Well, I can explain all of that to you.
I've listened to you for months. I've watched Parliament.
Yeah.
You're so, still lying.
Well, I can give you an answer right now if you'll let me. What I want to do is put a price on carbon pollution. Big polluters are going to pay.
I understand. Yeah, I've heard this 100 times.
If I can just finish, so we'll have less of it in the atmosphere.
This I understand that.
Which is a good thing. There's two main
I'm
ways.
Not stupid.
No, I'm suggesting that. Two ways of doing it. One is effectively a tax, a fixed price.
Look, Julia, I've heard you on Q&A, I've heard you for over a year, but the thing that sticks in my craw is you stood up and said there will be no carbon tax.
And I was talking
And a few months later, it's all coming out, excuse me, a few months later, you've changed your mind.
No, I haven't changed my mind. No, that's... If I can explain
well,
that...
How can you say...
I did talk in the election campaign about the need to put a price on carbon. And I talked about what's called a cap and trade scheme, where you cap the amount of
and
carbon.
And then at the very end, you said, there will be no carbon tax under my government.
Absolutely, I did say that. I talked in the election campaign about putting a cap on carbon pollution, an emissions trading scheme. We're going to get there via a temporary carbon tax to where I talked about during the election campaign. So it's a different route home than the one I thought we were going
same
to
outcome.
Use, but we'll
same
get to
outcome.
The same outcome. I
exactly
talked about
still
the
same
election. Well, I didn't mean to mislead, and I didn't foresee all of the circumstances
of
this
have
parliament. But you know, we're going to get there to do the right thing by our.
When you get in by manipulation, I'm sure. It's not so good.
You're making an assumption. Didn't mean to mislead anyone, and we're going to get where I wanted to go.
Well, when you start telling the truth, I'll listen to you.
Well, that was.
Okay.
In the sense is that we can, we will be a regulating intelligence for the planet, I'm sure, in future. And we will do what our brain does for our body, which is help create stability, coordination between the parts, and lead to a stronger Gaia, if you want, a stronger Earth system. The rock.
Well, this is just a complete joke, and it's such a joke.
Union. Can I ask you, do you think he should return to the Speaker's chair while these civil claims are still being played out?
I understand that the Prime Minister's addressed this in a press conference in Turkey in the last few hours. I haven't seen what she said, but let me say I support what it is that she said.
Hang on, you haven't seen what she said?
But I support what my Prime Minister said, so...
Well, what's your view?
Well, my view is what the Prime Minister's view is.
Surely...
Money. You have unleashed the lynch mob, and you have fanned it. And for that, you all ultimately are responsible.
Good evening. Former Labor MP Craig Thompson has emphatically declared his innocence after being arrested and charged with 150 fraud offences.
Chris, I'll leave the political commentary and hyperbole to you.
Who do you trust to manage the economy in the interests of working people?
There will be no carbon tax under the government I lead.
Who do you trust to understand the needs of the future and the building of that future economy? Who do you trust? Who do you trust?
There will be no carbon tax.
Thank you. I think, Prime Minister, though, Peter was seeking some sort of guarantee if you don't get the budget back into surplus in 3 years, what happens? Do you sack the Treasurer? Do you take personal responsibility?
It's happening, David, that failure is not an option.
If it doesn't, any guarantee?
Failure is not an option here and we won't fail.
All right. Our next question.